By our record, we are still having three of these AK-47 that are yet to be recovered. When the Minister of Defense came with the service chief, I did promise that first of all, we want to recover those arms. And the second aspect is to apprehend those who perpetrated this evil act, ensure that they are brought to book. And that process, we are starting it today, and already we have handed over the state that the constitutional deputy chairman, Sam Carvey, to the police for further investigation with the aim of ensuring that we apprehend those who were involved in this act. And also the councillor, Honorable Miller, who represent that community that these soldiers were attacked. He too, we have handed him over to the police. Chief Adegbenda, who is the kindred head of Bato, is also handed over to the police to help them in their investigation with the aim of apprehending the perpetrator of this act. And the fourth person is the district head of Ruanyam, Chief Unaha Koko. It's also handed over to the police. And we expect that these four people will provide useful information so that those who actually committed this crime will be apprehended, arrested, and brought to book. So this is to avoid the situation where innocent people will be punished unnecessarily. On the humanitarian crisis arising from the attempt by soldiers to recover their arms and recover the bodies of their colleagues, we have also sent the ES SEMA to Konshisha, and I am told that the report is ready so that government will see what can be done to provide some relief that will reduce some pains amongst those who are affected in this crisis. As we wait to recover the remaining weapons, as soon as we get enough feedback, we are also going to visit Konshisha. That is, the Security Council will also visit Konshisha to assess the situation ourselves. And lastly, the State Executive Council will also look at what can be done. The soldiers who were killed, we cannot bring them back to life, but we know they have families. So the State Executive Council will look at what will be appropriate to be given to the families of those soldiers who were killed, at least to also cushion some pains that they have, reduce the gap of the pains. So this is where we are, and those are the decisions of the council.